Dear delegates, dear colleagues, dear interested scientists, politicians, and stakeholders, as a representative of the University of Koblenz-Landau, I'm very pleased to welcome you here to this meeting of the Action Team 6 of the UN OSA, and I would like to particularly welcome the Minister for Health from El Salvador, who also gave a welcome note, and the ambassador to El Salvador in Germany, but also a couple of representatives from the UN OSA, for example, Maslan Otman, the Director General of UN OSA, and Sergei Chernikov, also from the UN OSA. And I would also like to welcome Pascal Michel, who is the chair of this meeting and was involved in organizing this meeting together with my colleague here from the University, Bert Niehaus. It is a joint effort to improve the environment and the public health that we face here during this meeting and during the whole initiative that we are talking about here. And we basically try to integrate environmental health and public health into a joint approach, the so-called One Health approach. And I'm honored here that the University of Koblenz-Landau plays a role in this attempt to combine public health and environmental health into this One Health approach, and also to contribute to analyze and provide tools for the analysis of spatial data at a global level in order to solve environmental problems. One of the problems that we are facing here is the problem of chronic kidney diseases that we have with large numerous incidences, for example in El Salvador, but also in many other countries, and that is one of the problems we are dealing with and for which we are very thankful that the whole initiative tries to solve this problem, but at the same time are honored and pleased that the University of Koblenz-Landau can play a role in contributing to this. Internationalization is a very, very important aspect for us here at the University of Koblenz-Landau. We are a rather small to medium-sized university, so we really try to increase the number of international students here and increase the number of exchanges between scientists from other countries and our university. I would like to give you two examples. One example is a summer academy on using spatial data and ecotoxicology that was held a few weeks ago here in Landau, and we had more than 20 delegates from all over the world contributing here to the summer academy, also delegates from El Salvador, and we discussed the problems and the various issues in these countries here in greater detail. Another example is a course that we have here, a master course taught entirely in English, which is a master on ecotoxicology, so the science that deals with chemicals in the environment, how to measure them, how to assess their effects, and how to assess the risks. And that is also an international course where we invite collaboration with other master studies, either here in Germany or abroad, in order to combine our knowledge and then jointly contribute to the capacity building in this area. And many studies also here from my colleagues in the department have shown in the past that even in countries like Germany, in the heart of Europe, we face still a lot of environmental problems with chemicals. Although we have a relatively good regulation of chemicals, we still see problems, for example, with some groups of vertebrate species like frogs, or we notice that the regulation and the pesticide registration, for example, still has certain problems that we need to deal with. And therefore, I'm very pleased once again that we have this project here and that this meeting is ongoing, and I wish all the delegates a very fruitful meeting and thank also the organizers of the meeting for their effort and time they spent in this meeting. Thank you very much.